Just Patty by Jean Webster. Narrated by Rebecca H. Lee. Chapter 1. Reform.
It's a shame, said Priscilla.
It's an outrage, said Connie.
It's an insult, said Patty.
To separate us now after we've been together 3 years.
And it isn't as though we were awfully bad last year. Lots of girls had more demerits.
Only our badness was sort of conspicuous, Patty admitted.
But we were very good the last 3 weeks, reminded Connie.
And you should see my new roommate, wailed Priscilla.
She can't be any worse than Irene McCullough.
She is. Her father's a missionary and she was brought up in China. Her name is Karen Hoppuck Hersey, after Job's youngest daughter. And she doesn't think it's funny.
Irene, said Connie gloomily, gained 20 pounds through the summer. She weighs...
But you should see mine, cried Patty in exasperation. Her name is May Mertel von Arsdale. Karen studies every second and expects me to walk on tiptoe so she can concentrate.
You should hear May Mertel talk. She said her father was a financier and wanted to know what mine was. I told her he was a reform judge and that he spent his time putting financiers in prison. She says I'm an impertinent child. Patty grinned feebly.
How old is she?
She's 19 and has been proposed to twice.
Mercy, whatever made her choose St. Ursula's?
Her father and mother ran away and got married when they were 19, and they're afraid she inherited the tendency. So they picked out a good, strict church school. May doesn't know how she's ever going to fix her hair without a maid. She's awfully superstitious about moonstones. She never wears anything but silk stockings, and she can't stand hash. I'll have to teach her how to make a bed. She always crosses on the white star line. Patty scattered these details at random. The others listened sympathetically and added a few of their own troubles.
Irene weighs 159 pounds and 6 ounces, not counting her clothes, said Connie. She brought 2 trunks loaded with candy. She has it hidden all over the room. The last sound I hear at night is Irene crunching chocolates, and the first sound in the morning. She never says anything, she simply chews. It's like rooming with a cow. And I have a sweet collection of neighbors. Kid McCoy's across the hall, and she makes more noise than 6 cowboys. There's a new French girl next door, you know, the pretty little one with the 2 black braids.
She looks rather desirable, said Patty.
She might be if she could talk, but she only knows about 50 words. Harriet Gladden's rooming with her, as limp and mournful as an oyster, and Evelina Smith's at the end of the corridor. You know what a perfect idiot Evelina is.
Oh, it's beastly, they agreed.
Lordy's to blame, said Connie. The dowager never would have separated us if she hadn't interfered.
And I've got her, wailed Patty. You two have Mamsell and Wadhams, and they're nice, sweet, unsuspicious lambs. But the girls in the East Wing simply can't sneeze, but Lordy...
Shh, Connie warned. Here she comes.
The Latin teacher, in passing, paused on the threshold. Connie disentangled herself from the mixture of clothes and books and sofa cushions that littered the bed and politely rose to her feet. Patty slid down from the white iron footrail and Priscilla descended from the top of the trunk.
Ladies, don't perch about on the furniture.
No, Miss Lord,
they murmured in unison, gazing back from 3 pairs of wide, uplifted eyes. They knew, from gleeful past experience, that nothing so annoyed her as smiling acquiescence. Miss Lord's eyes critically studied the room. Patty was still in traveling dress.
Put on your uniform, Patty, and finish unpacking. The trunks go down tomorrow morning.
Yes, Miss Lord.
Priscilla and Constance, why aren't you out of doors with the other girls, enjoying this beautiful autumn weather?
But we haven't seen Patty for such a long time, and now that we are separated, commenced Connie with a pathetic droop of her mouth.
I trust that your lessons will benefit by the change. You, Patty, and Priscilla are going to college and should realize the necessity of being prepared. Upon the thorough foundation that you lay here depends your success for the next 4 years.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.